So, Anthony, I spend a lot of time thinking about crabs.
Okay.
I mean, they are so fascinating. They have an incredible life cycle.
Yeah, they're pretty cool looking.
They inhabit almost every ecosystem on Earth.
Uh-huh.
They're even found on underwater volcanoes.
Pretty impressive species.
I know. And I think, you know, it's pretty interesting that if I were to put a picture of a crab up here,
yeah,
most people would be able to identify it, right?
I'd think so, yeah.
I mean, like, this is a porcelain crab.
Right.
It's a crab, right?
Yeah, well, yeah. You just called it a porcelain crab. It's crab.
Guess what? Not a crab!
What?
It's not a crab. I'm being serious. Absolutely.
The porcelain crab is not a crab.
It's called a porcelain crab, and yet it's not a true crab. There are lots of animals out there that aren't true crabs that look like crabs. They're called crabs, but they're not crabs. So I thought it would be fun to play a game and share with you some fun facts about some of my favorite species of crab.
Okay.
I would like to play a game called Crab or Not Crab. What do you think?
I'm game. Let's try it.
Right on. Here we are.
Oh, come on.
Crab or not a crab?
Come on. I mean, okay, so you got a scale there. 2,000 micrometers, is that? So that's like...
teeny tiny.
Okay. Most people don't think of crabs as little small ones, so... but you've got that face on.
This is just my face.
Yeah, can you see it? You guys see what I'm talking about,
this
right?
This is my face.
I think crabs have two pincers, maybe. Maybe big one, maybe small one, but like pincers. And then maybe they got like, I'd say like north of eight legs. This doesn't seem to have any structure at all. So I'm gonna say not a crab. Yeah, of course it's a crab. Of course it's a crab.
Crab! So this is actually a larval form of a crab. Crabs have an amazing life cycle, okay?
Right.
They start off as eggs, and then they enter this planktonic phase.
Right.
And this is the first thing they hatch into, which is called a zoea.
Okay.
And if you look at this, it doesn't look anything like
at
a
all.
Crab.
That's the first thing I noticed about it.
This does not look like a crab, and yet it is the first form of a crab. From here, they turn into a megalopa. From a megalopa,
that's a cool name.
They turn into a juvenile crab and finally sink to the bottom of the ocean floor and turn into your familiar crab
right.
that you would recognize.
Just like Pokemon evolving again, again and again.
Okay, so you're doing pretty good. 0 for 2. Let's move on. Okay. This
okay.
is a purple shore crab, Hemigrapsis nudus. If you were to ever come visit me on the West Coast, we would go down to the beach, we would flip some rocks,
yeah.
and we would find these guys.
These
they're
guys
pretty much everywhere. They're very common.
Okay.
Classic crab. Is this a crab or not a crab?
Well, I have learned a lesson from talking to you. I learned that you calling it a crab is not a good indicator of whether or not it is a crab. So. It's got more than 8 legs, so it's got like at least 8 legs plus 2 pincer things, and it looks like it's got a hard shell. I can't see the environment it's in, but I'm gonna call this a crab.
You are
yeah,
learning!
Baby.
Well done!
Oh, I'm
crab.
Learning!
Crab!
Okay.
This is indeed a crab. Okay.
You wanna finish?
Here we go. Now, this is a pom-pom crab. This is my current screensaver. It is the most incredible crab. What do you notice on its claws?
A lot of spirit. Got the pom-poms
there you
waving around.
Go. So the reason it's called a pom-pom crab is because it has anemones. Basically, it holds these anemones and they're kind of like captive bonsai trees. So if you were to find this anemone out in the ocean on its own, it would be large and full and lush, but this crab keeps them stunted, like essentially small, starved little
what?
Versions of their other selves, so that they're not too heavy and so that it can carry them around. This is the only species of crab that has effectively lost its ability to use its claws in the classic sense, which is to
wow.
eat and to feed itself. So why do you think it has these anemones?
So I think he's like waving these pom-poms around, capturing food, and then just like peeling it off.
You are right. That's exactly what it's doing.
Oh my God.
So it's waving
that
his pom-poms.
That is so cool.
The males and the females have them, and things stick to them. So they even use them like mops. So you'll see them going around the seafloor, mopping things up, eating them. The other neat thing about anemones is they're venomous. So they can use them to stun prey. They catch
Seriously?
Things, they eat them. They also can deter predators because nobody wants to come to something venomous, and they probably use them for camouflage as well. Is the pom-pom crab a crab or not a crab?
Well, my rule at this point, for no reason, with no background, is that crabs have at least 8 legs, and I'm counting 8 legs plus 2 pincers. I'm calling this a crab.
You are good,
yeah.
Anthony. Crab.
Yeah.
I like it. Very good. Very good.
Thank you.
This is a crab. Now, this one is really neat. This is a coconut crab.
I have seen these. These are the biggest ones in the world, right?
These are the largest land-dwelling invertebrates in the world. They're about 9 pounds, but they can lift about 65 pounds.
That's
a child, like a large child.
Yeah, oh my God, that's so scary.
Yeah, they're called coconut crabs because they love scaling coconut trees, grabbing the coconuts, and then...
This is fascinating.
So, crab or not a crab?
Okay, well, my arbitrary rules say 8 legs. I think this is a very freaky not crab. Yeah!
Not a crab.
Oh, awesome.
Good deduction.
Okay, thank
you
very much.
I like it. Okay, you have definitely seen this species of crab. This is called a king crab. You might have heard about a king crab in The Deadliest Catch, which is a very famous reality show. It follows fishermen in Alaska going out to the Bering Sea and fishing for this very lucrative crab called the king crab.
Right, right.
So, what do you think? Is the king crab a crab or not?
Okay, well, covered in spines. I mean, I've seen lots of different kinds of crabs now, so I'm aware that they can look quite different. I mean, my rules are the same, I guess, so I don't see 8 legs. I'm gonna say this is not a crab because of my 8 rule.
Not a crab!
Yo.
Well done.
Thank you very much, thank you very much.
Now, okay, this is called king crab. This is the king of crabs.
Yeah, and I've learned not to trust you when you call it a crab.
No, and yet it is not a crab.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing.
What the heck is going on? If it's not a crab, what is it?
But I mean, I've never seen anything else really. I mean, I've seen things like this, but I know it's not a crab, so I couldn't say what it would be.
So have you ever heard of the term carcinization?
I can honestly say I haven't.
Really? It's all over the internet right now.
What?
It's like a viral meme.
Okay.
It's this idea that everything is evolving into crabs.
I have heard this.
We're all turning into crabs. And people are actually slightly worried that humans are going to be next. Like, we are going to turn into crabs. Now, that's not going to happen.
No, I'm not worried about that.
Okay.
Yeah.
But it's kind of sweet because it's based on a scientific observation that other crustaceans are evolving to be more crab-like.
Interesting.
Yeah. So actually, in the last 180 million years, this has happened about 5 times, which is a lot. So why would other animals want to be more like crabs? What's so great about crabs?
My guess is going to be that these guys, like the body plan is just super helpful or adaptive or useful for some reason that I can't really guess at. I mean, I don't know why having a lot of legs would be handy underwater.
No, you're exactly right. Their body plan is very efficient. If you think about the body shape of a crab, I mean, it has that flattened carapace, right? And it's kind of wide like this.
The top part, that's the carapace?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, exactly.
Right.
Now, it's kind of hard, to be honest, to tell the difference between a crab and a false crab. But you were getting pretty good by the end with your own made-up criteria, which were pretty accurate. So the first one is that tail. Look for a reduced tail. Make sure if you're looking for a real crab, make sure that it has nothing here flowing out. It's going to be tucked up underneath its body.
Okay.
Right? The second thing, the antennae of a true crab are going to be between the eyes. Okay, and other non-crabs, they're going to be somewhere else.
There are antennae on that thing? You can barely see them.
You can barely see them on here, but trust me, they're there.
Okay.
Now, the last thing, which is what you clued into very quickly, is the fact that this has four pairs of walking legs and one pair of claws. Whereas a false crab normally, not always, but normally has three pairs of walking legs and one pair of claws.
Okay. Now, I mean, one question I would have would be, like, why do scientists even care about the difference? Like, what's the big deal?
I mean, it's true. We call this a crab because technically now we just accept that it is a crab. But if we're talking about where they come from, its genetic lineage,
right,
it's not the same. And so they evolved separately. Now, they are related, but they come from two different branches.
Okay.
So for people like me, that's interesting. But honestly, for everybody else, this is just a crab.
It's a pretty fun crab, though.
It's pretty,
pretty cool crab.
Okay, so lightning round. This is a box crab.
Okay.
One really neat thing about this crab, first of all, like, look at the shape.
It looks very cool, yeah.
Very like different shape, like a little helmet. Look what's on its right claw. It has a can opener.
What?
What? Over time, this claw has developed a little kind of hook so that it can crack into shells, break them open, and then eat the meat
inside.
That's
incredible. This one I honestly have a pretty tough time with because I can't see any antenna, or if there are antenna, I don't know what they look like. They're tiny. And then I cannot see the legs. All I see is just two big pincer guys in front. So this one feels like a 50-50 for me. Not a crab. It's a crab. Let's say, I'm going to settle on crab.
Crab!
Yeah!
I feel like you were saying not a crab.
I was saying not a crab.
And then you last minute changed.
I panicked, yeah.
Yeah, you were right. So this is indeed a crab.
Okay, very cool. All right. I think I've seen one of these.
Do you know what it is?
This is a Pokemon. I forget its name. This is Kabutops. And he evolves into Kabuto. No, he evolves from Kabuto into Kabutops. It's not a crab.
Not a crab. This is a horseshoe crab.
Oh.
They call it a living fossil. It evolved over 450 million years ago. So
wow.
It is old.
Yeah.
And do you know what it's related to? Arachnid.
This is a relative of a spider?
Yeah.
Or a scorpion?
Exactly. I
this
know.
Is where they came from.
And yet, they're called horseshoe crab. Yeah, so we're just calling everything crabs. Definitely not a crab. You know what that is.
That is a hermit crab, I believe.
You got it.
And that is, despite its name, I think technically not a crab.
Not a crab. Hermit crab, not a crab. Okay, the last one is the smallest crab.
Aww.
This one is called a pea crab.
Look at the little guy.
Because it's about the size of a pea. And you find them inside bivalves. I've found many, dozens and dozens in my clams over the years. And you eat them because they're delicious. But they spend their lives inside other animals.
Okay, well, let's apply the rules you taught me. So I see 1, 2, 3, 4 legs plus 2 pincers. I'm gonna call that a crab.
Crab!
Yeah.
So maybe it's not as hard as we think.
I will say that unless I knew you were trying to trick me, I would have assumed that they were all just crabs. I don't know that I would have been looking for a difference or any kind of pattern in there.
Yeah.
So because I knew I was looking for the pattern, I knew to find something, but otherwise.
And you know what, at the end of the day, does it really matter if they're crabs or not crabs? They kind of all look like crabs.
Yeah.
The point is, animals, crustaceans are evolving to look like crabs because it's a really efficient type of body.
Mm-hmm.
And so there's something to be said about being a crab.
I, for one, cannot wait for like a million years to see what humans look like.
We're not going to turn to crabs.
Well, I mean, you don't know that.
That was not the purpose of my lecture.
Thank you for showing me all about crabs. I learned a lot.
You like crabs now.
I'm a fan of crabs. Are they docile? If I saw one in the wild, could I, like, approach it? I mean, I'm not going to because it looks like an alien. I should try.
I mean, the book that I read said that they think that Amelia Earhart was actually eaten by coconut crabs.
Why? So why are you encouraging me to try?
No, I mean, I'm curious to know. Yeah.